Well, I can, and it's a brand new football league. Kind of. So, if you don't know by now, Dwayne Johnson, along with a ton of his investment partners, purchased the XFL all the way back in August of 2020 at the massive price tag of $15 million. And with the help of Redbird Capital and Danny Garcia, The Rock was able to make the deal just hours before the once bankrupt league was set for auction. Now, to understand why the league was bankrupt and on the verge of being auctioned off in the first place, we have to go all the way back to where it first started. And to do that, let's travel to the year of 1999, where a young Vince McMahon had a dream of a new ambitious startup venture. It was essentially football with a little extra something from the wrestling world. And with the WWE in its prime, McMahon had the money to spend. Now, Vince's plan to make the XFL stand out from its competitors was to make the league a more fun viewing experience for the audience by bringing everything he learned from the WWE. I'm talking theatrics, showmanship, women in not very much clothing. Some of their halftime shows were absolutely wild. Plus, the league had a handful of pretty odd and zany rules. I'm talking any name on the jersey, a cameraman in hockey equipment, and a slippery ball. Now, this new league consisted of teams across the country, ranging from the Los Angeles Extreme down west to the Orlando Rage out east. Hell, there was even teams as far north as the Bronx, with the league having a squad called the New York Hitmen. Now, the very original XFL was a joint venture between WWE and NBC, with the initial investment coming in at just above $100 million. But just because you got a lot of money doesn't mean shit, because this new league didn't last long, with fans tuning in for the first few months, but unfortunately for the league, it just wasn't enough for NBC to stick around, as they were unwilling to air the second season. And with NBC backing out of the deal, the XFL was forced to shut it all down. And given how badly the league failed, everyone thought McMahon was done with his dream. Everyone but Vince himself, because two decades later, the WWE star decided to run it back, and thus, the XFL 2.0 was born. Now, technically, this league wouldn't be a reboot of the original, but instead an entirely different corporation, with the new version of the XFL being entirely owned by Alpha Entertainment. And this time, the league wouldn't include any aspects of wrestling, and instead to try to take itself more seriously. And in the new XFL, the league wasn't going to give their football teams goofy-ass names like the San Francisco Demons or the Memphis Maniacs. And instead, the league would have more serious team names like the Dallas Renegades, LA Wildcats, and the St. Louis Battlehawks. With former NFL coaches and players trying to get another shot back into the big leagues, which is another thing I want to talk about. See, a key difference with the XFL this go-around is that it wanted to be more of a farm system rather than a competitor for the NFL, in the same way that the minor leagues feed into the MLB, or how the G League is used to help out the NBA. And honestly, everyone was looking great for the first 5 weeks, and it really seemed like Vince McMahon was able to achieve his dream, which was true up until a massive pandemic swept in and immediately started raining down on the league's parade, shutting the XFL down in a matter of months. As cost to maintain everything was astronomical, forcing the league into bankruptcy. And at this point, it felt like the league was cursed, because now bad luck has struck the XFL not once, but twice. However, there were a few good things that came out of the XFL 2.0, and those good things were players who made it to the NFL, with the most successful player being PJ Walker, which shouldn't be a surprise at all, because this QB balled the hell out with the Houston Roughnecks in the 5 games he played with the squad before COVID swept the world by its feet. What a story this man has been, with Walker being a 4-year starter at Temple from 2013 to 2016. And if you don't believe me, just check out this quick montage of the guy bawling the hell out for Temple. from Temple, PJ went straight to the NFL. Kind of. Well, he eventually signed with the Colts in 2017 after going undrafted. And from there, Walker would chill on the bench for about three seasons before being cut and stumbling upon the XFL. And in the XFL's first and only season, the 5'11 shot caller led the league in passing yards at 1,338 and touchdown passes with 15. Now, those stats are exactly why the Carolina Panthers gave the XFL star a two-year contract and a chance for the starting job. See, unlike his time in Indianapolis, Walker actually played this time, with PJ playing in a total of 15 NFL games and starting in 7 of them over the course of 3 years. But anyway, let's focus up. See, all of this leads straight to the present day, where a new WWE star has taken on the challenge of finally trying to make this football league successful long term. Now, the question is, what can Dwayne Johnson do differently for the league that Vince McMahon hasn't already tried? And to that, I say, Disney. Disney is what Dwayne Johnson brings to the table, and something Vince McMahon never thought to do. You see, back in May of last year, news came out that the XFL agreed to a 5-year deal with ESPN and Disney to broadcast their games, giving the network exclusive broadcasting rights for all game day content starting in 2023, going all the way to the 2027 season. Now, this league is set to have 40 games in the regular season, with 2 playoff games and 1 championship game that will premiere on ESPN, ABC, and FX. Now, the reason this partnership is so beneficial for the league is that a normal dude in his 30s could just turn on the TV, scroll to ESPN, and accidentally find an XFL game. And that's huge for the league. It's a way to open up themselves to a massive sports-loving audience, full of 30-year-old men with nothing to do in April. And that is why I believe that Dwayne Johnson has not only saved the XFL, but secured its long-term success. Alright, that's all that I have to say for the video. If the XFL ends up failing in the next 3 years, you can come right back to this video and talk your shit. Now, before I go, I just wanted to bring up Eric Bieniemy, because we're already on the topic of football and he probably won't get his own video. So I just wanted to say that I don't think Eric Bieniemy should have to go to a horrid franchise like the Commanders just to prove that he's good enough for a starting head coaching job. I mean, the guy has already proven he can coach. He helped build up Mahomes, who is arguably a future GOAT. If you want to watch me talk about the next superstar in the NFL that no one saw coming, click this video on the right. Or if you want to see me talk about the NBA and why the Lakers will win it all, click this video on the left. Catch y'all next time. Deuces.